Good morning. We begin with capital gain on slump sale. Okay. We know how to calculate capital gain already. Okay. We classify the assets into long-term capital assets and what? Short-term capital assets based on the period of holding. For example, listed shares and securities less than 12 months or 12 months or less, we take it as what? Short-term. More than that, we take it as long-term. Okay. In case of land and buildings, unlisted shares, we take it as what? Less than how many months? 24 months as short term, more than 24 months as long term. In case of other assets, 36 months we consider. Okay. For long term capital gain, we know how to work out. We work out the sale consideration minus indexed cost of acquisition, of course. Expense on sale, you reduce it to find out full value consideration. Then you work out indexed cost of acquisition. The benefit of indexation is available for all long-term capital gains. Then minus we do ICOI. What is ICOI? Indexed cost of improvement. Like that we work out. That is in case of normal capital gain computation. So slump sale means sale of assets, group assets along with liabilities. It's called a sale of undertaking. Sale of a part of undertaking. With its assets and liabilities. For example, you are having four businesses, you are selling off one business. When you are selling, business means it has both, financially means it has both assets as well as what? Liabilities. You are transferring one of the business, assets minus liabilities you are transferring. Okay. So when there is a sale of undertaking or sale of part of the undertaking or two or more undertakings, okay, as assets minus liabilities, okay, without assigning consideration for individual assets. I sell land and building, plant and machinery, stock, debtors, my liabilities for a consolidated price. Okay, while arriving at the price, I am not able to assign any individual value or value for individual assets. Then the slump sale arises. So if you look at, so what is the meaning? Number one, transfer of one or more undertaking. As a result of the sale, a lump consideration is involved. Without assigning what? Individual assets, value of assets and liabilities of such sales. For example, I am having 10 assets and 4 liabilities. If I can find out the value of each asset minus liability and work out consideration, this slump sale concept is not applicable. Okay. Without assigning the value for individual assets and liabilities, if I transfer assets, this slump sale arises. Okay. So it should be a lump consideration without assigning the value for individual assets and liabilities. You need not copy this. I am attaching a material for this where all these notes will be there. Okay. So there is slump sale. So the slump sale is covered by the special provision called section 50B. Okay. Where it cancels all the other provisions. For example, I am holding land for more than 36 months. Building for more than 24 months. Okay. Can I go for the benefit of indexation or can I do anything with that? No, please ignore all the other computation of capital gain. It has a special provision. What is a special provision? Period of holding will be determined based on how many years you run the business. For example, business was started and run for more than 36 months means the gain will be called as long-term capital gain. And if it is started for and run for less than 36 months means it will be a short term capital gain. So while deciding long term capital gain or short term capital gain, don't see how many years or how many months that individual assets are being used. For example, land that I would have purchased about 1 year back only, but still I would have run the business for more than 5 years, 6 years. It will be called as long term capital gain. Okay. With respect to slump sale, don't see individual assets period of holding. Okay. It all depends on what? The total period for which the business is run. Okay. When it is taxable, simple. When there is a transfer, it is taxable. Year of transfer. For example, I said I am having four businesses. One of the business I am transferring in the current financial year means it will be taxable in the current financial year. Okay, so how to calculate capital gain? Simple. Assets minus liabilities called as net worth. Assets minus liabilities we call it as net worth. Okay, so compare this net worth with sale consideration. Okay, sale consideration minus net worth will give us capital gain. So how to calculate net worth? The rules are given in section 50B. Okay, so net worth should not be determined by as you like. Okay, the rules are given how to calculate net worth. So do you understand? So how to calculate capital gain? Not based on individual assets value, lump sum consideration received, that is sale consideration. Of course, expense on sale you can deduct it, minus net worth. Then how to determine net worth? Go to that. Net worth means cost of acquisition and cost of improvement, whatever you have done. Then if you look at, while calculating net worth, for all non-depreciable assets you will take the book value. For all non-depreciable assets you will take what? Book value, like land, book value. Book value will be nothing but cost. Okay, for all depreciable assets, for all depreciable assets you will take the book value. Okay, book value as per Income Tax Act. Book value as per Income Tax Act. For all the depreciable assets, you will take WDV. WDV at the beginning of the year. WDV at the beginning of the year as per Income Tax Act. Then, for all assets, other assets like debt, stock and other things, you will take book value. You will take book value. Once again, if it is a not a depreciable asset, you take the cost, there is nothing but book value. If it is a depreciable asset, take WDV. What is WDV? As per Income Tax Act, WDV at the beginning of the year. Okay, number two. Number three, in case of all other assets, it can be current assets or it can be investments, all those things, you take which one? Book value, value recorded in books. Okay, you could have seen section 35 AD, specified business. When you acquire assets for specified business, like plant, machinery and all, 100% deduction is allowed. We had seen in PGBB chapter where if you acquire assets for specified business, 100% deduction is given in the year of purchase for specified business. Okay, so what will be the book value of asset? Zero. So simple, for the purpose of computation of net worth, book value of the asset will be taken as zero because you have already enjoyed 100% tax deduction. Okay, then sometimes in financial accounting, You would have revalued the assets and taken the amount to revaluation reserve. This slum sale section 50B tells you, please consider assets ignoring the revaluation effect. For example, land was purchased for 10 lakhs. We have done upward revaluation by 5 lakhs. Now the land is recorded at 15 lakhs. This accounting standard says, consider land at 10 lakhs. Please ignore that upward revaluation done 5 lakhs. Simple, in the balance sheet, if 15 lakhs is given, adjust the revaluation effect. 5 lakhs, you will consider the land without revaluation effect. So once again, how to determine net worth? Depreciable assets, WDV as per section 36. Okay, that is Income Tax Act. Opening WDV after depreciation allowable. Number two, okay, for all the other non-depreciable assets, you take the book value. Non-depreciable assets, you will take normally at cost price, including cost of improvement, if any. Okay, for all other assets, you will take the book value recorded in books. If any asset for which 100% deduction is claimed already, the book value will become what? Zero. Section 35 AD assets in general. Okay, then Please ignore revaluation effect. So these are the things to be considered while determining net worth. So sale consideration minus expense on sale will give us full value consideration, minus net worth will give us capital gain. Is it long term or short term? We had seen this already. Depends on period of the business. If it is run for more than 36 months, long term, otherwise it is short term. Indexation benefit is not available. Sir, land building is a capital asset. Sir, can I claim indexation benefit? No, under slum sale, indexation benefit is not available. So suppose if you sell two or more undertaking, you work out purchase consideration for undertaking one, undertaking two, calculate the capital gain separately. I told you this already. Revaluation effect should be adjusted. Otherwise, without revaluation effect, the asset should be considered. I told you, if the asset value is 15 lakhs, including revaluation of 5 lakhs, eliminate that 5 lakhs, take the asset at which one? 10 lakhs. No profits and gains from business or profession arises. For example, if there is a transfer of stock, okay, if there is a sale of stock, we call it as business profit. But when it comes to slum sale, we are selling the assets. All assets and liabilities for a consolidated price, no PGBB will arise in case of transfer of stock. Okay, so these are the points you have to consider. As I said earlier, I have given a material for all these things. So please do not, take up all these things. You can directly go through the material. Now we'll do a problem, okay, or we'll go through a problem where you will understand better about the slum sale. As I told you earlier, the notes are supplemented or supplied along with this. So don't, you need not write notes. So whatever I have given in PowerPoint is there in your notes. Now we'll do a problem or go through the problem. This is a flow chart of slum sale. Okay. Is undertaking is owned for more than 36 months? If the answer is yes, it is long-term capital gain, otherwise short-term capital gain. If it is long-term capital gain, we know it is taxable at the rate of what? 20%. If it is a short-term capital gain, it is taxable at your normal income tax law rate. Okay. How to calculate capital gain? Take the consideration minus cost of acquisition or improvement minus net worth. Okay, that is net worth. What is net worth? Assets minus liabilities. Assets minus liabilities. While taking assets, in case of depreciable assets, WDV. Then in case of assets where full depreciation is claimed, the value will be taken as what? Zero. In case of other assets, you take which value? Book value. Please ignore revaluation effect. We'll see the example. Mr. A, proprietor of Akash Enterprises, having two units. He transferred on 1/4/2019 unit 1 by way of slum sale for a consideration of 25 lakhs. So consideration is 25 lakhs. Unit 1 started in 2005-06. It is more than 15 years. So it will become a long-term capital gain. Expense incurred can be adjusted with this. Sale consideration minus expenses on sale will give us net sale consideration. The balance sheet at the beginning of the year is given to us. Okay, we are in financial year 1920, assessment year 2021. So opening balance sheet is given to us. So go to that. Capital revaluation reserve for building unit 1. So we have to take 12 lakh minus 3 lakhs. 12 lakh minus 3 lakh you have to consider. 12 lakh minus 3 lakh you have to consider as the building book value. 9 lakhs. Machinery you will consider book value, debtors you will consider book value, other assets you will consider book value. Then bank loan 70% for unit 1, 2 lakhs into 70% will be taken as a liability for unit 1. Creditors also 25% will be taken for unit 1. Okay, revaluation reserve was created on upward revaluation of building 1. This I already told you. 12 lakhs minus 3 lakhs, 9 lakhs you take it. No individual value of assets is transferred. Okay, is specified in the transfer deed. Yeah, it's a lump sum consideration. So it is not specified in the transfer deed. Other assets of unit 1 includes patent acquired for 50,000. So this 1,50,000 include patent acquired for 50,000 for which no depreciation has been charged. It was acquired on 1/7/2017 for 50,000. For which no depreciation has been charged. Patent is an intangible asset. What is the rate of depreciation? 25%, right? So for this 50,000, how many financial years are covered? 2017-18, 18-19. Okay, two financial years. Don't provide depreciation for current year. 19-20, don't provide depreciation. Okay, only. Okay, you have to take WDV of the assets at the beginning of the year. Current year depreciation will not be allowed. Okay, so 50,000 into 25%. That is for the first year. Into, again, you will get the resultant value into 25% for the second year. Even the first year, you know, block of assets method. The asset is used for more than 182 days. We can claim what? Full depreciation. Asset was purchased in July 2017. So for 17-18 financial year, we can claim what? Full depreciation, block of assets method, section 32, hope you remember. Okay, then for 18-19 financial year, again a full depreciation can be claimed. So let us prepare a working note for that. Okay, cost of the patent is 50,000, depreciation for the first year 12,500, and depreciation for the second year on this 25% 9375, 28,125. 28,125 is the value of which one? Asset. Book value of asset or WDV of the asset at the beginning of the year. Then for the purpose of computation of net worth, WDV is determined for depreciable assets. Balance sheet, okay, 12 lakh minus 3 lakhs. That revaluation effect you have to adjust and take it. You have to adjust and take it. Since the unit is held for, of course, in this problem it is 15 years, around 15 years. So it will be a long-term capital gain. More than 36 months, it is a long-term capital gain. So we ascertain the value of patents. We ascertain the value of which one? Patents. Okay. Now, we'll determine the net worth. We'll determine which one? Net worth. Clear? Patents, 2 years depreciation, 28,125. Building, we consider 12 lakhs minus 3 lakhs. How much? 9 lakhs. It is held for more than 36 months. It's a long-term capital gain. But section 50B is very clear. No indexation benefit is available. Shall we proceed? We'll work out net worth next. Then capital gain at the end. For building, as we have discussed already, 9 lakhs will be taken. Machinery, how much? Book value, 3 lakhs. Debtors also, book value 1 lakh. Okay. Patents, this working, 28,125, we will take it. Other assets, 1,50,000 minus this cost of patent included in this 50,000, net value 1 lakh. So 9 lakh, 3 lakh, 1 lakh. Patents, WDV at the beginning of the year. Then other assets, the other assets include 50,000 of patents, so 1 lakh we take it. Minus creditors, total creditors into 25%. Bank loan, total bank loan was 2 lakhs into 70%. 1,40,000. So this is liability. So assets minus liabilities will give us net worth. Assets minus liabilities will give us net worth. Once again, building 12 minus 3, 9 lakhs. Machinery 3 lakhs. Debtors 1 lakh. Patent 28,125, that is WDV at the beginning of the year. Other assets, since we have taken patent separately, other assets 1 lakh. Creditors into 25%, bank loan into 70%, whatever is belonging to unit 1. So 1,77,500. Net worth is how much? 12,50,625. So we determine the net worth. Simple. Now capital gain, sale consideration 25 lakhs. Minus expense on sale 28,000, we get net sale consideration. Minus net worth we worked out, it will give us long term capital gain. This long term capital gain will be taxed at the rate of 20%. At the rate of how much? 20%. If it is short term capital gain, it will be added with along with your other incomes, it will be taxed. Long term capital gain, it is taxed at special rate 20%. 25 lakh minus 28,000 net sale consideration minus net worth. Sale consideration minus net worth will give us a long term capital gain. A small recap. It is sold for 25 lakhs minus expenses 28,000. So net sale consideration is 24,72,000 minus net worth gives us long term capital gain. So how to calculate net worth? Assets minus liabilities at book value. Okay, WDV is a pattern at the beginning of the year, we take it. Then revaluation effect should be adjusted for your building so that you get the true book value of the asset. Since the unit is held for more than 36 months, it is a long term capital gain. Okay, this example too may not be relevant for intermediate level students, because for assessment of company is not covered for you, but it may be relevant for final students. But sometimes they can ask this in intermediate level also. It has two units engaged in manufacturing of computer hardware. The company has not paid for the provisions of section 115BA. As a result of the company has decided to sell the software unit as a going concern for a slum sale for 840 lakhs, okay. A new company called PHE Limited, which means subsidiary company selling the assets to holding company. Holding company is selling the assets to subsidiary company. Holding company is selling the assets to subsidiary company, a kind of a demerger. The balance sheet is given. Okay, fixed assets are given for software units, hardware units, debtors, hardware, software, inventories, hardware, software, general reserve, share premium, revaluation reserve, current liabilities are given. It is from April 2015. So if you take 15, 16, 16, 17, 17, 18, more than 36 months. So it will become a long-term capital gain. Fixed assets, which was purchased for 80 lakhs, revalued at 120 lakhs. So this 40 lakhs you have to adjust, revaluation effect, not the entire 240 lakhs. For this unit, what is the revaluation effect? That 40 lakhs has to be adjusted. Then, fixed assets of software units also represents 280 lakhs. That is 400 lakhs minus 120 lakhs being the value of land. Okay, being the value of 120 lakhs is the value of the land. Other assets are like 280 lakhs. So this 400 lakhs includes 120 lakhs land, other assets 280 lakhs. WDV as per the books of the assets, as per Income Tax Act is how much? 180 lakhs is given. Determine tax liability. Please read through the problem once again, then we will solve. Go through the problem, then we will solve. 840 lakhs is the consideration. So, holding company is selling to subsidiary company. Details about hardware and software unit is given. So, we are selling the software unit, right? So, details about revaluation, details about value of land, block value for Income Tax Act, all those things are given. They ask you to find out tax liability. It's a long-term capital gain for a company also. What is the tax? General income, 25%, 35%, depending on 30%, depending on turnover. And for long-term capital gain for a company also or firm also, it is going to be 20%. So, this is whatever I explained already. Capital gain arising without assigning the value of individual assets becomes what? Slum sale. It is more than 36 months, it becomes what? A long-term capital gain. In case of non-depreciable assets, land, 80 lakhs we will consider. This includes, okay, after adjusting that revaluation impact, 120 lakhs is a revalued figure. 80 lakhs is the book value. Option 1, you take 120 minus 40, 80. 120 minus 40, you can take it as what? 80. Or directly you take 80. Debtors at book value, inventories at book value, other assets, we are given so many information, okay. So 280 lakhs is the book, value of other assets, okay. Then all these things, books of accounts, doesn't matter. For all other assets, okay, depreciable assets, we will take WDV as per which one? Income Tax Act. What is WDV as per Income Tax Act? These things should not be considered. What is WDV as per Income Tax Act? This 180 lakhs will be considered. For other assets, 180 lakhs will be considered as per Income Tax Act. Then minus liability. Liability means the current liability of the software unit. What is the current liability of the software unit? 180 lakhs. So land, 80 lakhs. Debtors, 220 lakhs. Inventories, 70 lakhs. WDV of the other assets as per Income Tax Act. You get the total value of assets minus liabilities will give us net worth. Okay, now let us calculate the taxable amount. We know sale consideration minus net worth becomes capital gain. Sale consideration minus net worth becomes capital gain. Since it is more than 36 months, it becomes what? A long-term capital gain. It becomes a long-term capital gain. No expense on sale is given, I hope. So 470 lakhs into 20%. How much? 94 lakhs. For a company, if the income exceeds, for intermediate students, it may not be relevant because assessment of company is not covered. Okay. But for a knowledge sake, you can, nothing wrong in referring. Okay. For final level, of course, for more than 1 crore, but does not exceed 10 crore, what is the surcharge? 7%. 94 lakhs into 7%, 6.58 lakhs, 100.58 lakhs. Okay, so HEC, 4% applicable. So this is a tax liability. So sale consideration minus net worth, LTCG, tax at 20%, surcharge 7%, plus HEC, 4%. Now, if you look at the first line, holding company, that is this Epsilon company, is holding 90% of shares in another company. Holding company is having 90% of shares in subsidiary company. Is there a possibility to escape from this tax? Possible. We are holding 90% of shares in other company. When you acquire 10 more percentage, you will become 100% holding company. When holding company acquires further 10%, Epsilon Limited acquires, going to acquire 10 more percent, it will become 100% subsidiary company. You could have seen what is not regarded as a transfer. Transfer between 100% holding and subsidiary company is not regarded as a transfer. So simple, Epsilon Limited can purchase additional 10% shares. Okay, it can become a 100% holding company and transfer the assets. Okay, at that time, this transfer will not be transfer of software unit will not be regarded as transfer for income tax point of view. Number one. So no capital gain will come. This tax, 104.6 lakhs, you can avoid if you purchase additional 10% shares of the other company. That is only for tax planning purpose. So hope you understand slump sales. 1 minute to recap. Take net worth. How to take net worth? For depreciable assets, you take book value as per Income Tax Act. WDV as per Income Tax Act at the beginning of the year for all depreciable assets. Other assets, you take book value like inventory, stock, debtors, okay, all those things, okay. Then for non-depreciable assets also, we'll take book value. We'll take which one? Book value means cost, ignoring the revaluation effect. Minus liabilities of that particular unit will give us net worth. Sale consideration minus expense on sale, okay, will give us net sale consideration. Compare the net worth, you get which one? Long-term capital gain. Hope you understand. Okay, so for more lectures on this particular topics or income tax topics, either, okay, you can be a